Hi friends, how are you? In this video clip, I am going to brief you on basic dyes. Already I covered other dyes. Those are all reactive dyes, wet dyes, acid dyes, direct dyes, and also some classification of dyes. In this video clip, what I am going to discuss or brief you is on basic dyes. See, dyes are classified as water soluble dyes and water insoluble dyes. Also, other types of dyes are synthetic dyes, natural dyes. Okay, but compared to the basic comparison is the water soluble and water insoluble dyes. The dyes available in the market, that is in the form of ready-made form, in the powder form, sometimes paste form, used for dyeing of the fabrics or printing of the fabrics. Okay, even dyes are used for paper printings. Okay, see, basic dyes are water insoluble dyes. These are not soluble in water directly when the powder form or paste form of the dye is dissolved in water, like reactive dyes, like acid dyes. Okay, but the direct dyes, that is dissolved in water, is important. Basic dyes are water insoluble. Then how to make it dissolve in water? Without dissolve in water, the dye solution cannot be prepared. If dye solution is not prepared, how the adsorption takes place? The affinity between the textile fiber or the dye particle, it should happen. So to prepare the dye solution, the basic dye should dissolve in water. After dissolving only, it will absorb by the textile material. Textile material may be yarn or fabric. Okay, now see, in your college you might have heard or what I have studied, basic dyes are used for textile material made from protein fibers. Okay, see, acid dyes also used to dye protein fibers. What are those protein fibers? Naturally available fibers. Say silk is a natural available fiber that is in the filament form, that is a protein fiber. The substance present in the protein fiber silk is fibroin. Okay, next, other natural available fiber is wool fiber. Wool, you know, this is made of the protein substance keratin. Okay, these proteins fibers, whatever is their inside molecular structure, that is polymerized structure, the basic dyes are usually used to dye these silk and wool protein fibers, and also used to dye the synthetic fibers made from synthesized proteins, that is protein fiber made synthetically. Okay, this is one part. And also, in previous days or even nowadays, the cellulosic fibers, even this cotton fiber, is dyed by the basic dyes. In olden days, I will give in the side what are those the dyes are used to dye the cotton, but the result is that the fastness of this dye used for cotton is very, very poor, especially washing fastness. The cellulosic fibers, cottons, are dyed by basic dyes by the help of mordants. Additional process used to dye cellulosic fibers by the basic dye. That is mordants. Mordants are the chemical agents. That is also dyeing agents. Help to dissolve the basic dyes in the water. Okay, na? These mordants, first the textile material, that may be yarn or that may be fabric, is mordanted. Mordanted means it first the fabric or yarn of a cotton fabric is treated with mordants. Mordants, first the textile material is treated with the mordants so that it will make the textile material, okay, textile material to absorb the dye particles. Okay, this is one point. I am coming the main important point in this basic dye is what is the mechanism involved in dyeing of cellulosic fibers by the basic dyes. Not only cellulosic fibers, any dyes you take, wool, protein fibers or cellulosic fibers, what mechanism involved in this? Mechanism is there. That is, basic dyes, when dissolved in water, even after treated with the mordants, the ionization takes place in the dye bath. Is treated with or is to be neutralized with acetic acid or hydrochloric acid. Okay, to make them neutralize before they use for dyeing. In this case, for hydrochloric acid, the chloride of the base dye will create. That is, the dye is ionized into two parts. One is colored ion and second one is colorless ion. Colored ion is a cation, that is positively charged. The colorless ion is a negatively charged, that is anion. Okay, by this neutralization by acetic acid or hydrochloric acid, the colored cation is produced, that is used to fix on the anion part or site of the macromolecules of the cellulosic fiber or protein fibers. Hope you understood. The cation of the basic dye is a colored part of the dye and anion is a colorless part of the dye. For dyeing is required colored part, that is cation is required. Okay. If it is dyed with the cellulosic fibers, mordants are used. Okay, for protein fibers, no mordant is required. So, whatever the free dye having colored part, cation, is making electrovalent bond with the anion part of the or site of the macromolecules of the fiber so that the fixing of the color takes place. Okay, even after dyeing, the after treatments are required to improve the fastness of the dye or improve shade of the dye. Okay, now this is a mechanism, one simple mechanism is there. Okay, now this is about the basic dyes. Okay, Hope you have understood the introduction. This is a small introduction. There is not a lesson, in-deep lesson. Just the surface introduction about the basic dyes. Okay. Please subscribe to this channel. Click the icon bell to get the notification. Like it. Share it. Thank you very much for watching this video.